guys, it's SimLicy here, so welcome to another part of my Renovating EA series, and this time I am renovating this house. It's called Daisy Hovel, and it was originally a one-bedroom, one-bathroom base game starter house that came in Willow Creek, and I turned it into a two-bedroom, one-bathroom house for a single father and his son, and I just really liked this idea. I tried to make it look like the dad is really into science and, like, exploration. I was kind of thinking he has kind of a personality like the father from Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. Like, he's always messing with different gadgets and coming up with inventions, and some of them work and some of them don't. Sometimes there's, like, disasters, and his son, I think, might be into science too, and I haven't decided whether or not he's only into science because his dad is, and his dad, like, bought him this whole science kit and gets him all these school projects and, like, you know, signs him up for all these different things, and maybe the kid we'll continue with that path, and maybe he won't. Maybe he's into something else, like sports or art or something completely different than what his dad is into. I don't know. I kind of thought that would be kind of a cool idea, so I've been thinking about the bio that I'm going to give this family. I haven't created them yet, so I'm not exactly sure what their traits are going to be, but I'm excited to see them come together. But I just love their house so much. It's really similar to my renovation of the Streamlit single that's across the street. I took a lot of inspiration from that build anyways when I was doing the exterior kind of design, and I think it looks really nice, and I think they kind of match, which is also really nice because then they look like they belong in the same neighborhood, and I just really enjoy that, and I had so much fun with this renovation. It's like one of my favorite ones I've done so far. I think it's because the house is just so quirky, and right now I'm not furnishing, by the way. I was just making sure a living room and dining room would fit all in that same area because it's a really small house, and actually the lot is pretty big. And I thought about making the house a little bit bigger, but I decided to keep it small, and then I added a lot of, like, activities. There's, like, a side patio area where there's a barbecue, and then there's also, in the back, I put a platform for a rocket ship, and then there's a swing set and, like, a couple other things, like some planter boxes, and I can't remember exactly, but there's a few different items. I do move the house back a little bit because I felt it was very close to the street. And then just moving the porch because I felt like that side porch looked a little bit silly and I thought it would look better this way. And you may notice that the house to the left of it, if we're looking at it face on, it's already been renovated, and that one will be in my save file as well. But that one is a renovation that I'm not going to share with you guys because it's going to be one of the houses that you can move into. Each world will have one house that is empty, but it has the layout, so, like, the kitchen and the bathrooms are done, but it's up to you to move into it and, like, furnish it, because I think that's such a fun idea. So I've been mentioning that a lot lately, so you guys are kind of aware, because I'm not sure if everybody will think that's a really good idea, but I think it's really fun, and I feel like a lot of people probably move into a house and remove a lot of the furniture, change a lot of things anyways, so it's a way for you to jump into the game without having to move a family or change a bunch of furniture. You can just kind of, like, start your family and adapt everything, or if you would like to, you can definitely, like, move households around if you want to live in a different house, or you can go into the gallery and replace the house if it's empty and you want a furnished one or whatever. I think that'll be a little bit of an easier way to do it, but of course let me know what you guys think. So I am starting with the landscaping now, and I was originally gonna make the landscaping kind of messy, like he doesn't take care of his yard, so it, I don't think it looks messy. It's a little bit overgrown, but I still think it looks nice. Maybe he hires a gardener to take care of it, or maybe he's just lucky and the landscaping looks nice. I don't know. I think it looks nice. Anyways, maybe you guys don't agree, but I tried to make it look a little bit messy with still looking nice. I'm not sure if I achieved that, but there is the rocket ship platform, which I haven't added in a build other than my science museum in a really long time. And so I definitely have been wanting to add more of that kind of, like, large, quirky equipment, and the rocket ship was definitely one of them, and I think it suits the character that I had in mind for this house. And then his son has a swing set and the water balloon bucket so he can play outside. So I definitely imagine that the kid is really active, and that's kind of why I was thinking that maybe he's into sports and his dad wants him to be a little bit more into science. I decorated his room with lots of science activities, so you could kind of go either way. He could either completely follow in his father's footsteps or kind of have, like, a struggle with, you know, having a different interest than what his dad is interested in. I think that would kind of create interesting gameplay, and you could go either way with it. So that's what I was thinking, and then I just added a fireplace, or like a chimney right there, not a fireplace. And then back here, I just add some extra boxes and like a tank, thinking it was more supplies for him to build his rocket ship, or maybe other projects that he has planned for the future. So I definitely imagine he messes with everything, probably even like the weather machine. And I was thinking that there's probably always like explosions and like crazy noises and stuff coming from his house, and his neighbors were like always gossiping and like worried about what he has going on over here. And I think that's such a fun idea. I really enjoyed thinking of this household, and I'm very excited to create them. If you guys have any suggestions for their personalities, the father and the son, and what the father's career should be, I would love to hear them. So please leave them in the comments. And also, I think that they're gonna have a dog. I did put some dog toys there on the porch, and I put a food bowl in the kitchen later on. So I'm kind of thinking they should have a dog, but I'm not sure what kind. So if you guys have any suggestions for that too, definitely let me know. But here I am putting a table so they can sit down and have a barbecue. And I do these mismatched folding chairs, which I thought was a lot of fun. And then as for the decorations on the porches, I actually do camping chairs because I thought that was a really good idea, because maybe the dad just really hasn't spent the time to actually buy real outdoor furniture, and he's like, you know what, I already have camping chairs, why not just use them, and we can just pack them up and take them with us whenever we go camping. Because I definitely think he does that a lot too. I kind of imagined him to be a bit of a collector or an explorer, so he likes going to Selva Dorada, and he likes going to Granite Falls, and I don't know what he collects, whether it's rocks and minerals or bugs or artifacts, I don't know, but I kind of imagine that he's really into everything. Maybe he tries to pick stuff up for experiments, or I'm not sure, but if you guys have any ideas, of course, let me know. And then over here, I put a workbench so he could build some stuff, and then just some extra boxes. And yeah, I think it is such a cute house, just adding some lighting on the exterior. Now we are on to the interior and just putting a fireplace right here. And then as for the interior, I tried to go pretty cheap with the furnishing. It doesn't end up really being that cheap in the end because there's so much decoration, and the rocket ship I think alone is like 1,000 simoleons. But I tried to make it look like it was a little bit on the cheaper end. So yeah, it's kind of hard to do. I hope that someday we get a pack that has more like rundown items to where you can actually fully furnish and decorate a house and have it look cluttered and lived in, but not being like a 60,000 simoleon house, like still have it be like 20 or 30,000. I think that'd be so cool, like a hand-me-down pack or like a yard sale pack where it looks like every, I mean, we got some stuff with City Living, but if we got an entire pack, like a stuff pack devoted to like rundown furniture, I think that would be so cool. I'm not sure if it would ever happen, but I like the idea. But now I'm working on the kitchen and just using, they're not the like the grossest countertops, but they're the cheaper countertops, and then some cheaper appliances. And it ends up being a pretty nice kitchen, I think. I end up cluttering up the counters with like boxes of cereal and like dishes, and tried to make it look a little bit messy. Like he doesn't really spend too much time like cleaning house or organizing anything. Like he is so wrapped up in his inventions and his, I don't know, different little projects and things. Like he's always in his mind, so he doesn't spend too much time actually worrying about keeping the house tidy. But there I just put the food bowl, and then I do like a microwave and a coffee pot, and I use these ones in the brown swatch because they're hideous. I loved it so much, and I think they're like the cheapest ones that we have in game, because I imagine that they probably eat a lot of microwave food, and he's constantly drinking coffee. And yeah, I just really like that idea. And then just adding some dog treats so they can give the little doggy some treats, and then just adding some other clutter items and stuff. But at this point I was really wanting to add a washer and dryer, so I create this little hallway nook over here because I didn't really know where else to put it, and I didn't want to rearrange the kitchen or the bathroom, so I thought this would be a good spot to put it. And then the swatch that I used has the coin slots on them, and I just thought that was a lot of fun. Maybe he picked them up at like a used appliance center or someplace like that, and he doesn't really care that there's the coin slots, so I thought that was kind of a fun idea. And then over here I'm just adding a clothing rack and then the umbrella holder. And I have kind of a hard time at picking out curtains in this house because I didn't want them to look too fancy. I think I ended up switching them from the ones that I have now, but I thought about switching up like the color, and it was a whole process. But here is going to be the living room, and I thought about giving them some like crazy mismatched furniture, thinking that they kind of picked them up from different flea markets and, yard sales or wherever. But I don't know, it was looking a little bit too crazy to me, so I do end up making it a matching set, but I went with the cats and dogs ones, and I know I've used them a lot lately. I've gone kind of on a cats and dogs furniture kick lately. I'm not exactly sure why, but I just love those items so much. And I felt like it suited his living room and his style. And then there I just added some like computer parts, and then I put different little decorations around the living room. Just kind of like quirky things that I thought would suit the dad's personality anyways. And it ends up having a little bit of a mismatch to it because I put this tall green chair. It does have this blue throw, so it kind of matches the other furniture. I don't know, I think it looks mismatched without being too crazy. So I definitely had a lot of fun with it. And I wanted to use this collage of artwork that came with my first pet stuff, but I wasn't really liking the actual images that came in the frames because they're actually just like cartoon images of cats and dogs. And I wish that we would get more of those like collage pieces of artwork that had actual Sims in them rather than like, I don't know, cartoon. It looked a little bit too kiddish anyways to be in the living room, so I decided not to use it. And then over here is the dining table, and I went with these matching chairs that came with cats and dogs as well. And then we got another coat rack, and I actually cluttered up the top of the table with like a cookie jar and like a jar of olives or pickles or something, and a salt and pepper shaker, trying to just kind of make it look a little bit messy. And then over here I just hang up another piece of artwork, and I think it turns out to be a pretty cozy lived-in living room. I do like it a lot, so definitely interested to hear what you guys have to say about this house. And then we move on into the bedrooms, and the dad's bedroom I was having a little bit of trouble with when it came to play testing it. So if you do download this from the gallery, definitely make sure that you turn on move objects, that way everything places correctly, because I did have to shove the desk and the dresser into the wall a little bit more than I did originally, and I had to move the bed closer to the wall too, like into the wall towards the son's bedroom, because the Sim that I was playtesting the house with was having trouble walking completely around the bed. But before I uploaded it to the gallery, she definitely could make it all the way to the other side of the bed. So you could have two Sims sleeping in here if you would like to. So hopefully everything places okay, but if you are having issues, just move everything a little bit away from each other and it should work okay. Of course you could move things around. It could probably be organized a little bit better, but I liked how cramped and cozy it looked, and I loved that desk because it has so many clutter items already with like the book decorations, and then I just added like an extra file and a lamp and an airplane, and then I cluttered up the dresser with this fan and a duck statue, and then this really cool item that I haven't used a whole lot, but it looks like a treasure map and it has like rope and a walkie-talkie. I don't know, it's a really cool item. And then we got some like drafting supplies. And other than that, I just put some like artwork and stuff up on his walls. I put a bulletin board thinking that it was different little things that he's keeping track of, or I don't know, but I think it looks cool. And then here in just a second, I find this satellite dish, which I don't think I've used too much, but I thought it looked really cool on the outside of their house. So I definitely had to use it. And then I just make the final touches to his room, and that's what it looks like. And then this is going to be his son's room. And I try to just clutter it up as well, trying to like make it look a little bit messy, so he's got school projects and stuff laying around. And I also gave him that science table, that chemistry set, and I thought his dad bought it for him, but maybe he's into it, because like I was mentioning earlier, I'm not exactly sure if he is going to continue being into science like his dad or not. And I figured that would kind of depend on whatever story you wanted to go with if you decide to play with this household. And if you don't decide to play with them and they're just in the save file, then they could do whatever they would like. But kind of thought I would explain that to you guys in case you wanted to play off of that idea for the gameplay or not. Totally up to you. And then just adding lots and lots of toys around and backpacks and stuffed animals and just trying to clutter it up like crazy. And I think it turns out to be a pretty adorable bedroom. So something I should mention, since this was originally a one bedroom house, the before and afters are a little bit weird. So hopefully they make sense, but I hope you guys have enjoyed this renovation and hopefully you guys are looking forward to future ones. But thank you guys so much for watching, and please leave any comments or suggestions that you have, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye. I'm waiting at the doorstep, finally home. I've been gone for too long. Standing here a while just to take it all in. Radio's playing our song.
stood there smiling at me as so many times before. I never wanna be away, leave you again. You are all I want and more. It's true. Step finally home.